Hello guys, it's Deep Shah over here, and today I'm going to show you how to create this cartoon vector artifact without using pen tool in Photoshop. Also, if you want to learn how to create such cool things using Photoshop for free, then hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. So without wasting any time, let's get started. This is the model image which I'll be using in order to create a vector art. The download link for this image is in the description below. But I don't want to use this whole image and want to just keep the face of the model over here. So for that, select crop tool and then using crop tool, crop the image as follows. After that, cropping it from sideways to place the face at the center of the document. So this looks proper. After that, click on this tick icon to place it. Now let me just zoom into the document. Now after that, we need to make sure that the height and the width of the document should be between 2000 and 3000 pixels. So for that, go to image and then select option image size. After that, set the resolution as 300 pixels per inch if it isn't already. After that, set the height and the width of the document between 2000 and 3000 pixels over here. After that, click on OK. Now let me again zoom into the image. Now after that, we need to remove the background from the model over here. So for that, create a duplicate of this background layer by pressing Ctrl plus J. After that, hide the background layer by clicking on the eye icon. After that, select quick selection tool. And then using quick selection tool, make the selection of the model as follows. You can increase and decrease the size of the brush using the square bracket keys of your keyboard. Now after that, if you want to deselect a selection, then all you need to do is click on this minus brush icon and then click on the portion which you want to deselect. Now once the selection looks proper, after that click on refine edge and then hover over the edges of the hair to get a proper selection of that portion. Now once the selection looks proper, after that click on OK. After that, click on add layer mask icon, which will only keep the portion of the image which is inside of the selection, and remove the rest of the image. So as you can see, now the previous background is no more. Now we need to fill this image with that of white background. So for that, make the background layer active by clicking on it and then click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select option solid color. After that, set the color as white and then click on OK. Now we need to merge the model layer and the background layer into a single layer. So for that, press Ctrl and click on the model layer, which will give you the selection of the model layer as well as keep the selection of the background layer. After that, press Ctrl plus E to merge the two selected layers into a single layer. After that, let's create a duplicate of this layer by pressing Ctrl plus J and then rename the duplicate layer as model and the original layer as backup. In case we do something wrong, we won't have to start from scratch, and then hide that layer by clicking on the eye icon. After that, make the model layer active by clicking on it. Now after that, we need to add oil paint kind of effect to the image over here. So for that, you can use two options. Either you can use the default oil paint filter of the Photoshop, but that will add too much of the oil paint in the image, and we don't want that much. Plus, that option is not available in all versions of the Photoshop. So let me just show you another way in which you can add a little kind of oil paint effect to the image over here. So for that, go to filter and then sharpen and then select option smart sharpen. After that, set the amount as 80%, radius as 3 pixels and set the remove as Gaussian blur. After that, click on OK. So this increases the sharpness of the overall image. After that, go to filter and then stylize and then select option diffuse. After that, set the mode as anisotropic and then click on OK. Now we need to apply this diffuse filter 3 more times, but each time we have to give it from a different angle. So for that, go to image and then image rotation and then select option 90 degree clockwise. After that, again apply the diffuse filter and then again rotate the image. So like this, we apply 2 more times. So after that, you can repeat these 2 steps, that is the smart sharpen step and the diffuse filter step, any number of times as per the oil paint kind of effect you want over here. So I'm going to repeat these 2 steps one more time so that it looks proper. So after that, again go to filter and then sharpen and then select option Smart Sharpen. After that, I'm keeping the values as same and then click on OK. After that, let me just apply the diffuse filter one more time again. So as you can see, after applying this two steps two times, it starts to give some kind of oil paint effect over here. So after that, let's start with the steps in order to give the vector effect to this image. Basically, we will be giving this vector effect with different kind of filters. So for that, let's convert this model image layer into a smart object layer so that each of the filter is clearly visible. After that, create a duplicate of this model image layer two times by pressing Ctrl plus J twice. Now each layer will be highlighting the different kind of details of the image over here, so let's rename the layers as follows. So after that, make the detail one layer active by clicking on it, and then hide the rest two detail layers by clicking on the R icon. After that, go to filter and then select option filter gallery. After that, expand the artistic folder and then select option cutout. After that, set the number of levels as 8, edge simplicity as 3, and then edge fidelity as 2. After that, click on OK. Now after that, let's sharpen the overall image and give some contrast to the image over here. So for that, go to filter and then sharpen, and then select options unsharp mask. After that, set the amount as 100%. After that, click on OK. So now as you can see, we have the base portion of the vector effect ready, but as you can see, the image is looking a bit rough. So let's add some softness to these details to make it look more better. So for that, make the detail tool layer active by clicking on it and then unhide it by clicking on the eye icon. After that, go to filter and then select option filter gallery. After that, expand the artistic folder and then select option cutout. After that, set the number of levels as 8. Increase the edge simplicity to 5 and then set the edge fidelity as 2 and then click on OK. After that, double click on this icon to edit the filter blending options and then set the blend mode of the filter as normal and reduce its opacity to 35% and then click on OK. Now let's add the same filter one more time and reduce its opacity to 35% as well. Now after that, let's sharpen the overall image and give some contrast over here. So for that, go to filter and then sharpen and then select option unsharp mask. After that, increase the amount over here to 200%. Keep the radius as 2 pixels and threshold as 0 levels. After that, click on OK. Now reduce the opacity of the overall layer to 50%. So as you can see, this layer adds some softness to the details over here. To show you the effect, I'm clicking on this eye icon and then again unhiding it. Looks better, right? Now after that, we need to bring out the details of the main part of the image over here. So for that, make the detail 3 layer active by clicking on it and then unhide it by clicking on the eye icon. After that, go to filter and then other and then select option high pass. After that, you can set the radius according to the details you want to be displayed for this image. So as you can see, as you increase this radius, the more details will be displayed. But the 2 pixels radius looks fine over here. And then click on OK. After that, change the blend mode of this layer to overlay. So now as you can see, we have the vector cartoon effect ready. Now let's give some touch-ups to make it look more better. So for that, we need to merge the 3 detail layers into a single group. So for that, press shift and click on the detail one layer, which will give you the selection of 2 layers as well as give the selection of all the layers in between. After that, press Ctrl plus G to merge the 3 layers into a single group. After that, let's increase the shadows of the image to give some contrast over here. So for that, click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select option levels. After that, click on create clipping mask icon. After that, you can set the shadows, midtones and highlight accordingly. So now this looks proper. After that, minimize it. After that, again click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select option vibrance. After that, you can set it accordingly. After that, click on create clipping mask icon and then minimize it. Now after that, let's increase the saturation of the overall image. So for that, click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select option gradient map. After that, set the gradient as violet orange and then click on create clipping mask icon and then minimize it. After that, change the blend mode of that layer as soft light and then reduce its opacity to 10%. So as you can see, by adding these effects, the overall image looks such good. So that's it guys, this will give you a vector cartoon effect without using pen tool in Photoshop. Now if you guys like this video, then hit the like button. Also share it to the ones who might be interested in such videos and subscribe to the channel for more videos in Photoshop. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.